Here we are in the Rhode Show kitchen this morning. Chef Michael Sully Sullivan is here. Gulfstream Bar and Grill is the place. Only been open for just a couple of months. Bermuda fish chowder is what we are making. Welcome to the show.
Thanks for having me.
Thanks for coming in today. You're going to make chowder this morning.
I am.
Now, a lot of people here in Rhode Island, they have their love of chowder. What is different about this chowder? And tell us how you're going to put this together.
The difference with this chowder is it's the official soup of Bermuda.
Mm-hmm.
It's people that know it are very critical of it, so when I decided to do it, I had to get it right. And it's just basically a lot of local ingredients that all work with it.
All right, so go over the ingredients that we need to put this together.
We've got red and green peppers, Vidalia onion, celery, garlic, stewed tomatoes, white wine, sherry, fresh thyme, bay leaf, a Bermuda black seal rum, beef broth, beef gloss, Worcestershire sauce, and some beautiful haddock fillets.
Sounds good to me. Okay.
One of the key ingredients, Outer Bridges sherry pepper sauce.
And what does that give it a little kick to it?
Gives it a good kick.
A good kick. All right.
A good kick.
All right. So we will put this together. We will talk about the restaurant because, like I said, it just opened just a couple of months ago. And look, with the weather we've been having, it is it's a perfect restaurant to hang out in and get some great New England food. Back to you.
Thanks again to Discover Newport for bringing in Chef Sully from Gulfstream Bar and Grill, Bermuda fish chowder.
Yes.
A lot of people have different types of chowders around this time of year. Rhode Island, New England.
Oh,
Manhattan,
yes. Oh, yes.
You know,
the
fish chowder,
style.
Whatever it might be, seafood chowder. I love what you're doing here, and you have a kind of similar base that most people do for a chowder.
Yeah, I mean, it's onions, peppers, garlic, celery. I went ahead and started the process. Now this dish actually takes total about 2 hours to complete.
Mm-hmm.
So I went ahead and got things started a little bit.
And that length of time is really just to make sure all those flavors have enough time
together.
To develop.
Exactly.
Great.
So I started that. Then you just add your beef broth.
Okay.
And it's about 32 ounces of beef broth.
Mm-hmm.
Your stewed tomatoes will go in.
Yum. Do you have to crush those up any
more
than
that?
No,
we leave them whole, just as it is. Worcestershire.
Ooh.
About a half a cup of sherry. About a cup of white wine. Doesn't matter really what you use. I use Chardonnay just because that's what I have handy in the restaurant.
Mm-hmm.
Fresh thyme. Bay leaves. And then some demi-glace, which I use a powder and just add some water to it to thicken it.
So pretty simple to make there.
The dish is really very simple. It's just the biggest part is the time. It's just time consuming. A lot of prep involved.
Sure.
And then just hurry up and wait.
Yeah,
you get it all together.
Classic.
Once this all goes in together, you let it simmer for about 30 to 40 minutes.
Okay.
And let all those flavors just all start to come together.
Before you go and
add anything else in there. There's one more step after that. That you add your fish and a couple other ingredients, which we will get to later on in the show.
So this
simmers down a little bit, and
I love the medley of ingredients that you've added, you said, to that similar base. So now folks at home know what to do and what they can add to really create their own fish chowder. Like we said, we'll finish it up when we come back. We are back in the kitchen. We've got Bermuda fish chowder on the menu with Gulfstream Bar and Grill. If it sounds new, it is, right?
Yeah, we've been open about 2 months now. We are located in Portsmouth,
mm-hmm.
Down at the Melville Marina.
Beautiful spot right over
great
there.
Great location. It's right in the marina, overlooking the water. We've
mm-hmm.
got boats, we've got water, we've got gorgeous sunsets.
Outdoor seating, given that view.
We have a brand new outdoor bar we just built.
Oh, you just got my attention.
Yeah, right? We have dog-friendly outdoor seating, outdoor deck.
Nice. We can bring that pup. If you adopt
her,
you can bring her on down.
And have plenty of food on the menu for you. But
nice. Like this. Is the fish chowder on the menu right now?
Fish chowder's on the menu. I put it on. We've opened with a smaller menu, and we've been slowly adding things, but I just put this on.
Great.
And it's been well-received.
Absolutely. So, well, I can't wait to sample. Where are you in the preparation
process now? Once you get through this, you let all this simmer for about 30 to 40 minutes.
Mm-hmm.
Just let all those flavors come together.
Our show ends at 10.
Yeah, right. That's why I brought a finished product.
No, I'm just teasing you. But that's great stuff. The cauldron is steaming. I love it.
So then from there,
you can smell it down around the corner. Everyone is enjoying the aroma.
You know, we had the hoods on.
I think you're onto something here.
Yes.
Then we have at our Bermuda Black Seal Rum, we add some of that, a couple ounces of that.
Yum.
This Outer Bridge is sherry pepper sauce.
Is
fairly
this hot?
Spiced, little spicy,
okay.
But not too, too bad.
Sometimes you can smell, all right.
Yeah, it's got a few dashes, yeah, a few
okay.
shakes in there.
Good?
That's good.
Okay.
Look out.
I don't want to be too heavy handed.
And then the final is the haddock fillets. Beautiful haddock fillets,
absolutely
boneless.
Do
beautiful.
We slice these
nope,
before, or are they just going right
I
in?
I put them right in whole.
Put them right in whole. Yep. I did just wash my hands.
I did. Witness. She
yes.
did.
Me too. I saw
well,
her.
Well, I like to
I saw her.
Just reemphasize that, especially
so then the
touching fish.
Haddock fillets go in whole, and then this will actually simmer for about an hour to an hour and 20 minutes.
Right.
Beautiful.
Just let everything come together. The fish will start to break down and flake. And then once that fish is all flaked and it's beautiful, and then your dish is done.
Is this something, too, I'm guessing we could do in a crock pot as well? Or does it not take as well, given that the fish
it doesn't
might
take
fall
as
apart?
Well, because the fish, if you
okay.
put everything in there at once, the fish is just going to, like, get destroyed.
Good to know.
I think I heard you say earlier, it's a lot of hurry up and wait with this. You really need to exercise patience with this one.
Which is a challenge.
But it's a virtue, but it's all worth it at the end.
It is. Mm. It absolutely is.
Sure.
I mean, you know, during the process, just keep stirring it. I let it go for about 30, 40 minutes before I even touch it again.
All right.
Okay.
And then start breaking it down from there.
And let's talk about the response of the people to, you know, to Gulfstream Bar and Grill. I'd imagine people are lining up. They love the place.
They do.
Yeah.
They do. We did a lot of renovations. The place is absolutely beautiful.
Mm-hmm.
You have a view from out just about every seat in the place. You have a view of the marina and the water. Like I said, sunsets are, I don't know what it is about Portsmouth, but mm-hmm. the sunsets are absolutely amazing.
Going to have to head down there then and check that out.
Magnificent.
Definitely.
Indeed. Yes,
sir. All right,
so
this
one
sits.
This is the finished product here.
It's really kind of thickened up there.
Oh,
it does. It really does thicken up a bit. Once that fish starts breaking down, it'll start. It'll start.
You can see how it's all broken down that way. Perfectly. Beautifully, really. The haddock really just finds its way around.
And in Bermuda, they normally use grouper or snapper.
Mm-hmm.
One thing about the Gulfstream Bar and Grill is that I try and do everything that has a little New England twist to it. So our tagline
right.
is coastal cooking with a New England twist.
I like that.
So we do all the way up, you know, the Caribbean, Cuba, Puerto Rico, up through
mm-hmm.
there, but we do a little New England twist in every way. The haddock, down there, they'll use snapper or grouper.
Okay.
Well, this looks great. When it's served at the restaurant, do we get like oyster crackers with it?
No, but
no?
What you do get is, the way we serve it is we serve it with a side of the Black Seal Rum.
Oh,
okay,
and
yeah,
the
just
sherry,
as good.
And the chef, even better.
Even
and
better.
The sherry pepper sauce. That way you can adjust the seasoning.
Oh, my goodness.
To your own taste.
Send this
oh,
one on down
great.
To you, Michaela.
Thank you very
yes,
much.
Yes, please do.
Oh, smells great.
And I usually recommend I have people
know.
Try it a little bit, then add a little bit of the rum and try it, and then add
yes.
a little bit of the pepper Stay sauce here. And try it more.
I'm going to make sure before we try it, we really
yeah,
cool it down there.
Yeah, well.
But look at that, the chunks of fish and how that's really broken up. Like you said, that's a great tip.
Oh, that's fantastic.
Yeah. Sorry,
Brendan's loving it.
I wasn't
Brendan
sure.
Love it.
That's great, man. Well, hey, this is Chef Michael Sully Sullivan. Thanks, buddy.
Thanks
Thank
for having
you
me.
So much.
Thank you. Everybody, yeah, most people don't know my first name.
Beautiful. All right.
Not
well,
a
now
problem.
They do. He is from Gulfstream Bar and Grill. You can check them out. He was here courtesy of Discover Newport. Thank you for joining us. You'd like
Thanks
to get
for
the recipe,
me.
Learn more all about the new restaurant, check out roadshow.com.